Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Door here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to Shadowhunters Season 2, Episode 16, titled Day of Atonement. Given the past year's events, Simon struggles with observing the Jewish Day of Atonement, while Clary and Jace travel to Idris looking for Valentine. I mean, addressing the first half of that synopsis, yeah, it makes sense that after learning that, angels, demons, mythological creatures, supernatural creatures and everything exist in a very short time frame, and all the stuff that he's been subjected to, yeah, it makes sense that observing the religious holiday would be a bit of a struggle, especially when you can't say, oh hey, I actually know definitively some of these things are real. I'm not sure about the other stuff, but some of this stuff is definitively physically real. On top of that, he's also a vampire and can't touch any Jewish symbols of, Jewish symbols. I was going to say of something, but I couldn't think of anything to say. But, yeah, so it's understandable that he would struggle with that. And in the second half, we know that Alec and several other Shadowhunters attempted to escort Valentine to Idris. Most of the Shadowhunters appeared, except for the one directly taking Valentine, who was taken to Sebastian. And no one knows where he is because that Shadowhunter died. So we'll see what goes on with the hunt in 3, 2, 1, go. Also, I got my lychee cider here, so should be a little more put together for this. Oh, are we going to get some of Cleophas? That's who she was. So I may have been wrong about being a little more put together, but also, what the hell happened to him? Oh, I think I know where they are. Oh yeah, I forgot to talk this in the last episode, but remember how the episode prior I said, oh, that's a bit of foreshadowing where the episode was bookended by Jace playing a specific thing on the piano, saying that Valentine taught it when he raised him, and then at the end we see Sebastian playing that exact same piece. Anyone undead in here? You don't know what that is. It's understandable, but also fasting as a vampire is dangerous in and of itself, add on top. Hello, Robert. Another thing I've forgotten to touch on, specifically since we know the show's gone in a different direction, is after Imogen died at the end of book two, Aldertree actually became the Inquisitor. I had a feeling if this was when this was going to happen. How fitting that it, how fitting that it looks like a lake and its tributaries. That is the one rune that only Clary herself can draw in the books. And she still somehow ended up in the lake. There's the City of Glass. Azazel have been in Edom. Who said anything about death? If it's what I think it is. Are you really thinking Imogen and Robert? How about the Tyrone? That looks to be a shattered portal. Chase? Well, that was a lot of blood. Well, that would explain the whole burning thing. Rebecca's a bit suspicious. Of course, Robert's going to recognize it. It is you, Isabel. Okay, so it does come up. And which angel is this exactly? Thuriel? You've had a bit of a glow up. really wants to hear what he regrets. Okay, well, I guess that cleans their hands of him. Well, I guess remote activation on another person is going to be in store. You know, it's real interesting that they gave him the golden eyes when he activates his power, considering he's meant to have golden eyes all the time. Is this Oh, it's something we already knew. Okay. That's what I was expecting. When I saw someone walking away with it, I thought it made sense. Because I think I made a comment saying I think I know who that is. Gotta send a message. So I'm confused. Does she live at the Chinese place? Apologies for the messaging. We're moving houses and gotta get this sorted. He wasn't. Okay, so not how I was expecting the episode to go. I was very confused about, were they actually going to send Valentine into Edom? Because we don't actually learn about Edom until book 6, in the fact that that's an actual place. And going back to a question I asked in the episode, why was Azazel in Edom? Edom is the realm of Lilith and Asmodeus, and was at one point the realm of Belial. But it was always Lilith's domain. Then Belial stole it from her. Then actually in the second sequel series, the Shadowhunters got it back from him for her, and then she just sort of co-ruled it with Asmodeus in the modern day series. So at no point was Azazel ever there. But the reason I said in the reaction was she still somehow ended up in the lake is because when Clary first discovered that she was able to make portals, she actually It was in book three, after Jace, the Lightwoods, and Simon had left through to Idris, after Valentine sent a horde of Forsaken to attack them. Clary actually makes a portal, and her and Luke go through. Luke actually is trying to stop her, because you can't portal into Idris. You're going to get bounced off the wards, and they just so happen to land in Lake Lynn. Clary, of course, takes a mouthful of lake water, because she's just suddenly been thrown into a lake without any preparation, and Luke pulls her out. She does lose her stelly, though. And because of that, it's not that it causes hallucinogenic effects in Nephilim. It doesn't downworlders. It's sort of psychedelic for some of them and a source of temporary power for others. But it's actually quite deadly if a Nephilim ingests it. And so Luke has to basically carry her, sneak her into Idris through the wards, and he takes her to the Greymark house because he knows that his sister, Amethyst, who he hasn't spoken to since the Uprising, she knows how to cure this because she's got a lot of different herbs and tinctures in her house. And so he goes to her to get Clary saved. And she's like, fine, but you need to leave. We can't, downworlders aren't allowed in Idris. So if you get caught here, and also because there's still bad blood between the siblings. But yeah, so that's how Clary ends up staying with Amethyst. Luke actually goes back and takes control over the pack of werewolves in Brosselin that he used to be the leader of. And then the other events that I've spoken of from book three happen. So in the same way that she was tossed in the lake, had the person who went through with her pull her out, she'd ingested some of the water and has these side effects. It was just Luke, not Jace, and she needed a special medicine as opposed to a stele. So I will say there's no thing of Sebastian ever having been sent to Edom, like banished there by Valentine or anything. So that whole part of his character is different. He was actually raised sort of alongside Jace the whole time, because when Jace was a child, Michael would go on missions. Those missions were actually him going to raise and train Jonathan when the members of the circle that were still loyal to him and in Idris weren't available, and he needed a more hands-on approach. He'd go on a mission away from Jace to go train his other son. And it was sort of comparing them. He trained them both on the same things, taught them the same things at the same time, like, and yeah, it was to see whether the angel blood or the demon blood would be better. He actually favored Jace in the book. Jace was the one that he ended up caring about. For him, Jonathan was always a weapon, always something to be held on a tight leash so that he couldn't do the stuff that this Jonathan was able to, like kill people to experiment on them. And it's because he was genuinely caring towards Jace as to why he sent him away in the end. Yet he kept Jonathan to be trained further because he didn't care about him as much. and could just see him as a means to the end. But, yeah. Also, they're sort of bringing in the whole Maya and Simon relationship. It is a bit different from how it was in the book, because, well, at this point, Simon had his own apartment. And, yeah, so he'd invite her over, they were just hanging out as mates, she'd come over to play video games and everything. Then one day, she just kisses him, and from then, it just, they're basically together. But at the exact same time, he'd been hanging out with Isabel, and she also just, the spur of the moment, kissed him. And they develop, and yeah, that's the thing that happens in book four. But anyway, was an entertaining episode. It was nice to see Simon actually spending time with his family, because at this point he's been kicked out of his house because his mum found out he was a vampire. He encountered her. She then remembered everything and actually loaded up all of the entrances of the Lewis household with different Jewish symbols so that Simon couldn't enter. Like, he actually burnt his hand on a, Now, the Star of David was when he was locked up in Idris. He was repelled from the house. And so, yeah, he went and started living on his own. But that doesn't seem to be happening. It could still happen, but yeah, who knows. Anyway, with that being said, I'll catch you in the next one.